As you have demanded.
I will go over it again.
If only for emphasis. Following the operational resolution of the board, a number of issues arose. One of them was Mr. Ryoka. Mr. Ryoka's, you know, removal from the board. Now, like it was explained again on the network, Mr. Ryoka is the acting commissioner of information technology in the ministry. Mr. Ryoka also is a member of the governing council of Uganda Institute of Communication Technology, based in Macau. Mr. Ryoka also sits on a number of committees in a number of ministries where ICT support is required. He also coordinates a number of projects, including the Pan-African Network, which, among other things, intends to strengthen e-education in Africa, as well as e-education, telemedicine, and other things. In brief, Mr. Ryoka is quite a busy man. Now, under government, it is not written anywhere in the law that you do not sit on more than one board. However, it is good governance practice that one should not sit on 3-4 boards, and you know, at the end of the day, be less efficient. However efficient you are, if you are sitting on a number of boards, you become less efficient, not because you are by nature so, but by physical division of your own time. But again, I say, it's not written anywhere in the law, and it shouldn't be that. But it's a good governance practice that when you do what, you give chance also to other Ugandans. It is very rare that there is such a specialty that there is only one person with that specialty, not even experience. So it is a good practice. Now, the law empowers the Honorable Minister under the article to re-evaluate and rectify issues. It is against that background that the Honorable Minister terminated the membership of Mr. Ryoka on the board. Not that Mr. Ryoka was inefficient, not that there was anything else, but because of that. It's purely because of that. That's one aspect. The other aspect that followed operationalization was that two members of the board, in the names of Mr. Ibrahim Kalisa and Miss Betty Kasimbazi, also tendered in putting an intention to resign. Mr. Kalisa again was by virtue of his work. Mr. Kalisa, if I may add, is the special presidential assistant on ICT. It was approved by his supervisors that apparently the little of work he had, the workload, could not allow him to consistently and effectively contribute to the deliberations of NITA-U Board. Mrs. Betty Bigombe is Undersecretary in the Ministry of Finance, Planning and Economic Development. And Kasimbas is Undersecretary Ministry of Finance, Planning and Economic Development. Again, it was the issue of the workload, which had not been taken into consideration at the time of appointment that he resigned. She's putting an intention to resign. You know, you gave her 1 month notice. I think Simba's notice has not yet expired.